you brought me coffee.
Didn't have time to do a real intro because I was running late because I booked the hotel for another day and I didn't realize it. And so I was checking out, they're like, you have another day. So I call Emirates and I'm like, guys, please let me hop on a flight tomorrow. Like, I want to stay in my hotel. They didn't have anything open tomorrow in Dubai to Lisbon. So we're here. A little sad to leave Dubai, but onward and upward. Entree was this mushroom eggplant dish, so I did not get it, and instead I picked and chose from the menu itself. So literally I have the entire vegan mezze and then a salad, and I have some vine rolls in the corner. Like, this will be very legit. Their mezze is unparalleled. So the salad, I don't know what this is, rice, beets, quinoa, I don't know. And just coincidentally, the plane begins to suffer extreme turbulence, basically, from this.
Apparently, the line of immigration is insane, so we have makeup out. We're going to be doing makeup and flight. We have coffee, we have snacks, and plug in my straightener and curler and new hair, too. Time's of the essence.
We have arrived, or I have arrived, in Portugal. I was doing my makeup. Usually I do my eye and face makeup, and then I do my hair, and then I do my lips. But the flight was actually a really good, like, 8.5 hour. It was, like, 8 hours. Like, no major turbulence really at all until we landed. Like, literally none. Like, literally, like, even me, plane phobic, like, literally no major turbulence. 8 hours. Emirates, thank you for your planes and your pilots. I could tell we were going around some stuff because I could just see on the flight path, and I was like, props to you. But we checked in at this hotel, Pestana Palace, is like really like weirdly set up. It's beautiful, but like you take one elevator up and then you walk down and then you take another elevator down to get to this where I am. But the room is really cute. So like, I don't know, bathroom is pretty normal, pretty standard, nice little, it's very cozy. This is very not Dubai. Like, I feel like I'm in an alien world here. But like, this is very old money. This is very cultured. We have like two beds here. We have a mini bar that I was already showing. I put my makeup over there. A little desk, a little blue couch. If this was red, imagine what we could do here if this was red. And then a little window that goes out to nothing. In the morning, I'll show you. It's just like tree there, but it's cute. I'm gonna get back to doing my makeup and unpacking a little bit. I'm really tired. Like, it's like 8:30 here now, and in Dubai it would be like 12:30. I look like I'm high. I'm not. I just did my eye makeup, so my eyes are a little red. But I need to go to this Galactic Geckos event. I might go and then I might dip. We'll see. I don't know how late I want to stay out. I feel like I should have stayed in Dubai until like the very last day I needed to be here because I missed Dubai. And I found out that I had an extra day on my hotel reservation that I should have used. But alas. So, see ya. Off now to registration, which I don't know if I'm even registered for this since I'm emceeing. Like, I don't know. I'm in this like totally winter 2019 and 2020 outfit, the snake pants and this top, which is fine. Have a little jacket because it's like 60 degrees, so it's chilly in my book. I have been filming some TikToks outside because in the daytime, this is fucking beautiful. Like, look at this. Eek, please open window. Like, in the daytime, I was, like, filming TikToks out here, but there are fucking thorns all over the place, and so wounded on my Chiron line, wounded as Chiron was, bloody knees, but it makes the red, the sunlight in the red, it's a mood. Acai stains on lips, it's going to be a trend, they're going to be copying this in, like, 6 months. Went to registration, didn't want to film because that would have been totally cringe. I was already awkward because I'm like alone. Like, everyone is kind of in their like, I don't know, company or developer group or whatever. And then it's just me. And like, everyone knows who I am. So no one is bothering to like, everyone just thinks that I'm like there for a reason. And I mean, I am. I'm like, I'm emceeing. Like, I have my fucking badge and all. But like, it's funny because when people think that like everyone else is talking to you or everyone else is like inviting you to something, it means that no one is talking to you and no one is inviting you to anything, which is fine. Like,
like, I don't care, like, I'm chill, whatever, but, like, yeah, I was not gonna film in the middle of, like, just overall me being cringe, but yeah, I went to the conference, got registered, got acai, and now have been going through some emails, prepping, like, posts. I think I'm gonna do a video on Travis Scott right now for TikTok. I need to look at his astrology and see if he has an astrology, or, like, he has a verified birth time and see what's going on for him, because he just had those crazy, like, astro world, insanity or whatever, so I do want to look into that story and then his astrology coming up. I'm going to try to film my 2022 year ahead forecast a bit before I have a client a little while. She's a recurring client, a badass boss. You know who you are if you're watching this. And yeah, looking forward to that. Or maybe I'll film them after. I don't know. I'm exhausted, but I do want to film a couple of these 2022 year ahead forecasts. I cannot do them all in a row. It's going to be like 30 minutes of video for each. So definitely not doing that. But we'll get into at least like one or two maybe today. So yeah, so gonna do that. I'm already feeling the Chiron line vibes in terms of like just feeling very vulnerable. Like these like social situations usually, I mean, I am the most like chill ever. Like I'm both awkward and cringe and also I don't give a fuck. So like I can just stand there alone and not have to look at my phone. But like, I really feel like I'm like really, really cringe. Like I'm always awkward and cringe. So in a way it's like, I don't get fearful about social situations because I'm always just like, I'm just gonna stand against the wall and like pout and wait for someone to come talk to me kind of thing, which is fine. Like, and then I'm like the life of the conversation. Once I'm in a conversation, I'm always fucking entertaining everyone. But like, I just feel very much like very, I don't know, vulnerable, which is a total Chiron kind of move. Like very vulnerable, which it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Day one of the actual conference, and I'm not actually emceeing today, but I do need to like be there, so I emcee like the rest of the conference basically, like the opening day. They're having like a bunch of other people do it, but yeah, I'm feeling like profesh. Like this is a kind of a profesh outfit. I have a bomber jacket as well. I'm gonna try to leave a little bit early right now so I can get TikToks like in the hotel because it's so beautiful and so like quiet, and I'm hoping none of people are out yet so I can like take TikToks and like the staging area and shit, because it's beautiful. It's fucking beautiful. Like my trading desk today was like the most beautiful like setup with like the deck, and like I got the one shot outside or the one spot outside. It was just cute. So we're gonna try to struggle bust it out in TikTok. I didn't redo my hair today because I curled it yesterday and it looked so good just like brushed. So I'm like, okay, we're gonna go with it. I'll redo it tonight before I go out because this is like, I don't like wearing makeup all day and then at night, but you know, so we're gonna have to do today with a little cut I have there from, I have like a face razor that I use for like no hair on my face, and yeah, it cut me. Filmed a fuck ton of forecasts. Jesus Christ, I'm running late for these events. We have a little, let's show the moment. I don't have my heels on, but I don't fucking care right now. We have the wrap moment. I don't know. This is like the comfiest fucking outfit ever. It's just like the wrap and then this. I don't know, I fucking love this outfit. This is like comfortable, it's nice. So we're about to go out to like three parties in a row. I'm gonna go to like 20 minutes each because I can't be bothered to spend like a whole entire party. Like I get my selfies with people who want them because that's what this conference has been, a line of people wanting to get selfies with me, which is fine, like whatever, I'm a spectacle. But yeah, we'll do this in a row and then come back here, chill, tired until tomorrow at like 8 a.m. when I have to be at the venue to MC. Oh my God, I did not think I could get any more fucking exhausted, and ooh, Jesus motherfucking, I mean, like, I have been up since 7, like, conferencing from, like, 8 to 6, like, leading this conference. I look high, I'm so tired. I'm not high, I don't smoke weed, even though I think it's legal here in Portugal. My outfit today was pretty cute, though. I don't know if I did, I can't even fucking remember if I showed you all this morning what I'm wearing, but I literally can't even be bothered to, like, film TikToks of this tonight. I'm wearing the, this shirt that has like a little keyhole cut out like in the chest. I'm wearing these pants from like 2018 that are Dolls Kill patchwork pants that God knows if they still make them anymore. And I'm also wearing my sparkly shoes that are like platforms that you can't really tell are platforms, but they're fucking like, these are like 3-inch heels actually, these motherfuckers. They're pretty dope in my opinion. I'm sure you'll see them in like TikToks and shit that I post. They're really cool. So they're very comfortable. They're very
platformy. And in Europe, oh my god, I forgot after like studying in Spain, I forget that Europe, all the hills and the cobblestone streets are terrible for heels. Like, you literally cannot wear like despicably high heels here. And I wear really high heels that are easy to walk in because of the platform. But like, no matter how easy the platform is, if they're really high, you're gonna fucking tumble over on this like uneven ground. So basically, I've just been wearing like, yeah, these. And I cannot go out tonight. I literally can't go to these parties. I don't give a shit. I can't. I just can't. I'm too tired. I need to like do shit anyway. And like, oh, so much to do. So I'm filming like two of my yearly. I'm gonna film more right after this. I'm gonna film more just so I can fucking get it over with. I've had this lipstick on since 7 a.m. It's disgusting. My makeup is faded basically because I don't wear enough face makeup for it to like blotch out. It just like fades. But it's okay. It's all right. I'm gonna get through it. Place for me to film in here. It is so loud, but like the theme of this video was about to be like how my Chiron line is like ultimate cringe. So I feel like filming in like out in public is like the most cringe thing ever. I could probably find a quieter place, but like this actually, the lighting is actually pretty good here, at least if I can set this up any better. I don't think it's gonna get any better than this, but I think this will keep people away from approaching me. It's been like the past like 3 days I've just been like a line of people asking for selfies. You know what? I'm just gonna fucking hold this because there's no other way for me to do this well. Basically, before we get into it, as always, recommend that you buy your Bitcoin on Swan. If you're going to do so, you can use my ref link down below. Not sponsored, just like the easiest place to buy Bitcoin in my opinion. Dollar cost average, buy repeatedly. Really hope that you're able to hear me in here. We'll see. I'll redo this if you can. Basically, I knew upon traveling here that this was right on my Chiron line, and I have Chiron right on my midheaven, which is why like everything I do is eternally cringe, because Chiron is like, it's an asteroid, and the myth behind it was, if I'm not mistaken, like feel free to correct me if this is wrong, I've heard a few different variations, but essentially like the myth was that Zeus had a kid with a nymph, and because Zeus was a god and like the nymph was like a mortal, the kid that they had named Chiron, like no one wanted it because it was really weird. It was like a demigod, like it was half god, half living, and so no one wanted anything to do with it because it wasn't like anyone else. And so it was a he. I believe it was a he. Correct me if I'm wrong about that. But he went into the army and he ended up getting injured. But because he was immortal, he was like forever wounded. That's why he was like known as the wounded healer, because he ended up teaching others like what he most needed to know. And so if you have that prominently in your chart somewhere, it generally shows that your worst, like most ashamed, like vulnerable part is what like others tend to see. And so I think of it as like the like extreme cringe point, because there's just no way around it being extremely cringe. And I think that having it on my midheaven, which is like the most public part of the chart, goes to show like why, like I talk about this often, but like sometimes it gets so bad to where I'm like paralyzed with cringe. There's people around watching this, which is so cringe, but the cringe can get so bad to where it's like immune, like it's overwhelming, like it will stop me and just like wince. And the overall like experience being here, like I actually really like this city. Given like the incentive for crypto and just overall like welcomingness to that, I wouldn't be opposed to like getting a place here and possibly a golden visa. I definitely, the pace of European cities is like not my thing, if that makes sense. Like I'm more used to like much faster pace, but I really like it. It reminds me of Barcelona, like it's beautiful. I forgot when I came here that like in Europe, the cobblestone streets are the worst possible thing for heels. Like you cannot wear, like it's just thin hell actually, like trying to like walk in like my shit all over the place. But besides that, the vibe that I get is like feeling very introverted. Like this whole entire 3 days has been like everyone like recognizing me and being like, I want a selfie, which is fine. Like I love like giving people like, I don't know, getting to meet, like I'll never complain about that. But I feel so introverted here, and so it's been this discrepancy between like everyone wanting like 5 minutes or like a time to like be able to say that, and me being like, I don't know, just like anywhere else in the world is probably a better fit for that in some cases. Like, I feel very, I don't know, like the last thing I want to do is go out. And even the venues themselves have been really cool here. I really like Sky Valley, where like one thing was, and the venues themselves are really cool. But I just feel like staying home and like not wanting to go out. Even the acai bowls that I had to check out here, I got one from the therapist, and that one was like not my favorite. It was too thin. Like, other people might like soupy acai. I like thicker, like almost like you have to like dig into, I don't know, I just like much thicker consistency. That one was okay. It was pretty good. Flavor profile on point overall, like not my favorite. The one from Fauna and Flora was like amazing. Like, that was that consistency, just overall very on point. I'm probably gonna go back there, maybe try another one of their flavors with the therapist today, because it's right in here at LX Factory, which is like actually a really cool venue. But overall, the way I describe it is just like, if you're on your Chiron line, like you're kind of introverted, like I feel pretty safe, but like I don't want to go out and see others right now. I don't know, I just kind of want to be kept to myself. And cringe, like mega cringe. I don't know how else to put it. Just like, I have Chiron exactly on my midheaven, general lip, so it's like me doing like just abrasively provocative things is so cringe, but like I do it anyway. And then also it's exactly square as my degree, which is, I'm still seeing how that manifests, but I think it's the fact that like even my values are like kind of cringe. I don't know, just like everything, like my values are so cringe. Like, I don't drink, like I'm like a vegan yogi, like something about that is just kind of cringe. So overall, the vibe for Chiron Line that I would say is like vulnerable, sensitive, kind of cringe, not bad. Like, I wouldn't avoid visiting it, but I'd say it seems like, I don't know, I just kind of want to curl up into a ball, which is like ironic because there's so many people here right now, which is fine. It's whatever, like there's people watching us, it's whatever. But I felt like in my element, in a way, I guess you could say, given that like being on stage and all is like my element. So I did feel like, since Chiron's on my midheaven, like I had like a public position almost this whole time, which is also fine. In regards to like Lisbon as well, I just think it's a beautiful city. Like I said, definitely somewhere I can see myself like getting a property one day as I build up the portfolio and like look for a golden like visa. Like, I would be actually down, like after being here for a few days, low key kind of want to extend my trip. But then again, I have so much luggage. Like, I was thinking about going to Italy or Spain, just like myself after this, but I have so much luggage. Like, I'd rather just go like literally just another 8-hour flight back to New York and then like back here, I don't know, November, December. Let me know what places in Europe would be good in like the holidays, because I don't like spending the holidays. Like, I don't know, I just, you all know, like I don't really have like family. It's like, I don't like the holidays because it's like, I don't know, everything's closed and I can't do anything. And so I like going places. So let me know like where is not too cold. I don't mind the cold. It's just like the actual day-to-day hassle of like somewhere that's freezing. So let me know somewhere down below, like I should go for Thanksgiving or Christmas, that is not freezing beyond belief around that time of year. But yeah, to summarize, I would say you'll probably experience cringe, maybe feeling like safe, but like mostly cringe. It's not bad though. I don't mind it. I don't know. Maybe I'm used to the cringe. It depends on Chiron in your chart too. Like, if you're not a heavy Chiron person, like not everyone has it prominent in their charts, it's probably not going to be a big, probably won't be that big. Like, or maybe actually someone who doesn't have it very prominent in their chart probably would be very like grossed out by the level of cringe versus like me, that's like extremely prominent, just used to it by now. But besides that, yeah, I recommend that you try those places in Lisbon. And the actual thing that I highly recommend is I stayed at the hotel, the Pestana Palace. It's literally the most beautiful thing ever. It's like not an abandoned, but it's like an old palace. It's a little bit outside the city, like a 10-minute drive from like the actual like center of the city where everything's kind of walkable. But it is so beautiful. I mean, like, it's this old palace and the buildings are all like windy and you have to take all these bridges everywhere. Even like me, I just got like a normal room because it's just me. Like, I'm not gonna get a like really like big suite or anything. It is like, it's like fucking beautiful. And like the gardens and the pool, it's the kind of place where if I ever, I guess in another 6 years when I date someone for 1 week, I would bring them there because it would be a really good place for like a honeymoon. But I would rather go during the summer when it's like hot to everyone else but decent to me, because it's cold right now. Like, it's kind of shady, and so like the pool itself was really freezing, which was also cringe. Like, I set up my camera, I needed to get content. Like, the place was fucking beautiful. I don't know anyone there. Like, everyone's really serious. I'm not gonna ask anyone to help out with this. So I set up like my phone on my tripod, like my this camera on my tripod, and just film myself like all over, and I take like screenshots for what I use photos. And it was beyond cringe. I mean, these are like serious European families being like, what the fuck? But they don't bother you, like they just go back to like smoking their cigarettes or whatever. So TLDR, beautiful place, high energy, here is very rich, but no complaints. So yeah, hope that this is helpful. Hope that this inspires you to visit your Chiron line, even if you're mega cringe like me, because it's probably worth it, especially if it's here. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. So yeah, I wonder where I should visit next. I've done almost all of them except for like North Node, South Node, or like Mars line. Actually, no, I haven't done like near me. I haven't done Venus line. Like I haven't done like most of these planets and shit. So yeah, see you next time. Take care.